When we played it for the first time in the rehearsal room, it had a different title then, a working title. It wasn't called No One Like You, but it was the same thing. I felt like, wow, this is something, it is so catchy and so clear and so inspirational, because in the beginning it was only the chords. And there was nothing else, so I had to come up with that intro melody. And you can always tell if there's some inspiration in a song, then you come up with a better idea. So you could say simply, the better the song, the better the playing on top of it.
But also the record company didn't notice that will be so big, because there wasn't a single out. Mm-hmm. In this case, that was the reason then maybe the Def Leppard, when they came with their stuff, they came out with singles in this way. You know, nobody believed that this kind of song can be maybe go in a top 100 or something like this. In this case, we had the most played song, but not with we had no single out.
I just start out the second half with the harmony,
right?
I've been playing. It's played, it's like a double lead, it's a harmony lead, but live I have to compromise. You know, I only have two hands and one guitar. But we make it even sound better, because the front of the house mixer, he adds like a major third through his harmonizer for this one spot, and makes people think it's two guitars they're hearing. So that's the compromise of doing like harmony in harmony leads.
Rocked Like a Hurricane, it was really the connection of, you know, this Rock You Like a Hurricane is a very kind of way, if you don't have the lyrics, which has the double meaning and the kind of sexual vibe, You know, where you know the bitch is hungry, she needs to tell, give inches of fear. Well, this double meaning kind of thing. I remember that Klaus and Hermann, they came around 7 or 8, 9 times to Dieter Dirks, the producer, with a new lyrics kind of concept, and always, and we, but when they came the 9th time, and we heard the lyrics come to the hook, we said immediately, yes, that's the one. Because everything is fits perfectly, and the song is now like Carlos Santana. When I met him lately in Germany, he said, "You know, this Rock Like a Hurricane becomes an anthem because many people using it now in the film Knocked Up. It's now in it, and it's fantastic." And the good thing about the whole thing was also that the effect in the verse after the solo, which the snare backwards, that was an idea from John Bon Jovi's
uncle. Tony Bon Jovi.
Yeah, he was in the power station mixing, yeah. And we somehow said, because we said to Dieter, you know, it would be great to have a different mixer, but he was very into it to mix it by himself. But we forced him so much that we were sending Rocky Like a Hurricane to New York, and then we got the result back, and there was this backwood snare, which we said, "Hey, that's a great idea." So, and then he mixed it again, or we mixed it again, because there were some mistakes in it, stuff like this, and then the whole thing.
Yeah, it's because it has like a third verse. We used to have third verses like after an instrumental part many times at the time. Today, for some reason, nobody does it anymore. Songs have to be like, you know, under 4 minutes, hopefully, and stuff like that. And so a third verse needs a different arrangement. And usually after like a solo instrumental part in the middle, usually in our band, usually guitar solo, you have to like, in dynamic-wise, bring it all the way down. And that's why we didn't have the same guitar arrangement. So we had to do something with the drums. So it's just drums, bass, and vocals. So that's where the effect came from, because it needed some extra effect.